Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn or revise this lesson, the Rat Trap. Lesson 4, Flamingo, from a book that is Rat Trap. This lesson is a beautiful lesson to teach lots of messages to the readers, to the society. Let's begin this lesson. That this is a story of a man who was a vagabond, who was a wanderer, who used to move from one place to another. He was a beggar, he was a thief. If he was not given anything as alms, he used to thievery, and he used to move and move and move. And the next part of the story is he had his own philosophy. The term rat trap is a metaphor. Now, metaphor for human suffering, metaphor for human predicament. Dear students, you can remember this question or this statement that the story Rat Trap is a story of human suffering, is a story of human predicament. Elaborate, explain, and the more we proceed with the story, more of our answers will be. So, let's move and journey into this story. That is, this chapter, Rat Trap, has the most important character, the tramp, the vagabond, the wanderer, in the who's the rat. We are calling him by the name of wanderer, by vagabond, by tramp. Calling him by these names. And he has his own philosophy. What is that philosophy? That is that the whole world is a rat trap. The rat trap is similar to the world. Or world itself is a rat trap. And when he moves with this philosophy, that world is a rat trap, he feels everyone is his enemy and no one, he has never received pleasant moments, or he has never received kind gestures. He has never been treated kindly by people. So whatever you receive, you give to the people. Whatever you get, you share. So he received all these things which are not good for human psychology. So he returned those to the world. And page number 32. But one day this man had fallen into a line of thought. What was this line of thought? Take 1 minute and open your books, the Rat Trap, as we are moving into revisions. So, one day this man had fallen into a line of thought. What is this line of thought? Which really seemed to him entertaining. He had naturally been thinking of his rat traps when suddenly he was struck by the idea that the whole world is a trap, is a rat trap. The whole world with its lands and seas, its cities and villages was nothing but a big rat trap. It had never existed for any good purpose, any other purpose than to set baits. The world is there to offer lots of baits to us, and we are often trapped in those baits, as a rat is trapped by a piece of bread in that small cage. So what is this bait? The tempting things that trap us, these baits. They attract us, we want them, we long for them, we try to captivate them, we try to get them, and we are fallen in the trap. This is Rat Trap's philosophy, the wanderer's philosophy. Right? That the whole world is a rat trap and we keep on running behind these temptations, attractions, right? And he also mentioned it offered riches and joys, shelter and food, heat and clothing, exactly as the rat trap offered cheese and pork. And as soon as anyone let himself be tempted to touch the bait, the moment anyone tried to touch the bait, like a rat, he was trapped, it was closed, it closed it on him, and then everything came to an end. So NCERT question, what was Rat Trap's philosophy? about the world. What was the wanderer's feet? He can be called, as I said, wanderer, vagabond, the tramp, the rat trap, right? The man with the dangling rat traps on his shoulder. The physical appearance of this man was very poor, beggarly-like, and he used to carry the dangling, the dangling here means that on his shoulder, the rat traps that he used to make from the raw material that he used to get from the waste of the small business houses, shops, and where he used to get those wires and connecting things, and used to make rat traps and sell them. And they were not sold. Petty work that he used to do of selling rat traps. So rat trap has got now two meanings here. One on the surface, that is the man used to sell rat traps. Second meaning, the rat trap as a trap for the old world. So inside meaning, the figurative meaning of the term rat trap. And if you see the book, on the top of the book, there's a picture of a small rat trap. You see, the picture has its own significance, right? Now moving further, this man was wandering one day and he reached outside a cottage, which he knocked at night. He was welcomed for the first time in life. He received some kindness, some love, some concern. So the theme of the lesson is also not only the story of this rat trap, but the under the canopy of, you know, love, affection, human need for companionship. All become desperate when they are lonely. So there was a crofter who lived in a cottage. He opened the door and welcomed this man with food, shelter, porridge, you know, food he offered him. Then he also played with him the cards. Not only this, he also told him his secrets, that he has some money in his house. And he also brought that leather pouch and took out 3 kroner notes, which he showed to this rat trap, this vagabond. And when he showed this, his eyes gleamed. Next morning, they got up. They both left the cottage. He also confessed that he has a cow and once used to work in a factory in an iron mill, the crofter. His second character is the crofter. So he told all his secrets and confidences he shared. And this way, this rat trap was lured. And now the bait became that money. Both of them got up early morning, next morning. But what happened? The twist in the story, or you can say a turning point in the story, that this man received kindness, forgot all the kindness of the last night, and came back and broke the window where the pouch was hung. And he took out the pouch. He took out those 3 kroner notes and went away, forgetting that he is actually stealing his benefit, whom he shared yesterday, not only shelter, but food, but clothing, everything, whatever he had, he shared with him. He gave him his rugs to cover himself throughout the night. The night was of, you know, chilly night, so he shared with him. But what was the result of that sharing? He stole, the rat trap stole him and went away. And in these thoughts of stealing, he went into a forest and he got lost. After that, he reached in an iron mill. Another phase of the story, the part of the story, the owner of the mill came and tried to persuade him because he thought that he's known to. So the iron master came. The owner of the mill wanted to take this rat picker home, but the rat picker refused. He was again persuaded by daughter Edla Wilmans. Now this daughter Edla persuades him or pursues him in such a good manner, in such a pleasant manner, that rat trap couldn't say no. He goes to their house. When he sat in the carriage, he was again reminded of the philosophy which he was reminded in the forest when he was lost, that the whole world is a rat trap. And if I had not stolen 3 kroner notes, I would have not lost in the forest. If I had not said yes to this girl, Edla Wilmans, right, I would have not been in this carriage and I'm entering into another rat trap. So So the whole world is a rat trap, according to our protagonist, the rat trap. I hope you have understood the two different meanings of the term rat trap also, right? So this way he journeys into their house, and there they, when his clothes, when his everything is changed, the man, the owner of the house next morning comes to know that he is not the one whom I had known. He is not that acquaintance. He says, "What is this? I'm going to call the sheriff. I'm going to call the police." Now, let me read for you. It was probably on account of all this noise that the blacksmith did not notice that the man had opened the gate. So when he had entered into the mill, no one had noticed and he did not receive any good gestures. Then when the master came, he took him home. And when he took him home, he found him that he is my comrade, old acquaintance, known person. But in the house, he realized that he was not his friend. He was someone else. And when he found this, he scolded him. "Now, well," said the iron master, "it was not quite honest. You must admit that, and I must not be surprised if the sheriff would like to have something to say to you in this matter. Now I'm going to call the officer, police officer. He'll talk to you for this dishonesty." The tramp took a step forward and struck the table with his fist and said, I'm reading page number 39, last paragraph for you in this revision session. "Now I'm going to tell you, Mr. Iron Master, how things are," he said. "The whole world is nothing but a big rat trap, and all good things that are offered to you are nothing but cheese rings and bits of hope set out to drag a poor fellow like me out of his house, out of his place, out of his senses. And if the sheriff comes now and locks me up for this, then you, Mr. Iron Master, must remember that a day may come when you yourself may want to get a big piece of coke, and then you will get caught in the rat trap." So he started preaching him. He started teaching him. He started telling him, right, that if you will today get me caught, you will one day find yourself in the rat trap. The iron master laughed a lot, and the daughter requested the father not to throw that man out of the house, as they had themselves brought him home for Christmas, and the next day was beautiful celebration of Christmas. And so the daughter was feeling little Christmassy, and she wanted that this man should stay with them. Now the theme again comes up. The chapter Rat Trap covers the theme of basic human need for companionship. It was not only the need of the rat trap for a companion, but also the crofter who had given him shelter, but also Edla, who wanted someone to be at home with whom she can celebrate Christmas. The father and the daughter were also lonely, right? So the story stresses on the fact that the most of us, most of the human beings, are prone to fall in the trap of material life, material benefits, material things. The author targets the materialistic approach of the people as the another theme or the next theme. The worldly riches have disillusions, are disillusions, and they disillusion us. And they are running, and we people are running after the things which are temporary, which are not permanent, which do not give us peace and solace, which do not give us happiness inside. So the story of Rat Trap is moving further. Edla Will Manson is kind, compassionate. She's taking care of a rat picker who was very dirty. The father told her that he would soon change, when the clothes will change, when the manners will change, and we'll soon give him some work to do. But the next morning when he comes for the breakfast, they realize, especially the father, he realizes that this is not the man whom I've thought as my comrade, my companion of the regiment. So he becomes furious. And when he becomes furious, he's being preached by the rat trap that you yourself will fall in the trap one day. But finally, they allow him to stay for a day. On the Christmas Eve, he is called for next morning when the Christmas is there for 2 days, he enjoys there. Next morning, when the girl and the father, Edla and the father, the iron master, they went to the church, When they go to the church, they find out that a rat picker has been moving in the area. A man with the dangling rat traps has been moving in the area. And the crofter who informed in the church, or who informed to the people there in the gathering, that he has been stolen and his money has been stolen. When they came home, they asked the servant, "Has he taken anything?" "No," the servant answered. "No, he has not taken anything. Rather, he had left something for Miss Edna." Now let me read the concluding part of the lesson. "Yes, that was a fine fellow, dear daughter, you let him in the house," said her father. "I only wonder how many silver spoons are left in the cupboard by this time." The wagon had hardly stopped at the front steps when the ironmaster asked his servant, the valet, whether the stranger was still there. He added that he had heard at the church that the man was a thief. The servant answered that the fellow had gone and that he had not taken anything with him at all. On the contrary, he had left behind a package which Miss Will Manson was to be kind enough to accept as a Christmas gift. He has not taken anything, rather he has left something as a gift for Miss Edna. The young girl opened the package in excitement. It was so badly done that the contents came out into view at once. He did not know how to pack the gifts. He has never received gifts. He has never given gifts. So she gave a little cry of joy. She found a small rat trap. What he has gifted to Edna? A small rat trap. And in it lay three wrinkled 10 kroner notes that he had stolen from the crofter's pouch. But that was not at all. In the rat trap lay also a letter written in large, jagged characters. What was that written? A small piece of message. "Honorable and Miss Noble Miss, since you have been so nice to me all day long, as if I was a captain, I want to be nice to you in return, as if I was a real captain." So he was not a captain. "And for I do not want you to be embarrassed at this Christmas season by a thief, but you can give back the money to the old man on the roadside who has money pouch hanging on the window frame as a paid for the poor wanderers. The rat trap is a Christmas present from a rat who would have been caught in the world's rat trap if he had not been raised to a captain, because in that way he got the power to clear himself. Written with friendship and high regard, Captain Von Stone." Now this man wrote a small message for Miss Edna, for her kindness, for her concern, for her affection, for her care these 2 days, 1.5 day. And the return is a rat trap. And in that there are two things. There is not just the rat trap, but there is a letter and that money which he had stolen. There is complete transformation of a thief into a good person. And what made that transition take place? That was the kindness and goodness. Essential goodness of a human can change the world, can change culprits, criminals, can change the convicts into simple, God-fearing human beings. So this happened with the rat trap. If we go through the summary that we have discussed just now, and if we go through these questions, how does the peddler interpret the acts of kindness and hospitality shown by the crofter, the ironmaster, and his daughter? Three people had been kind to him now, before stealing the crofter. The crofter was very kind to him, gave him place to live for a night. He gave him porridge, he played with him, shared his loneliness with him. They were not lonely for a time being. And the ironmaster, who allowed him to come to his house, who sent his daughter, right? And his daughter, who had been very, very kind and considerate in treating him nicely, even when his father was ready to throw that man out of the house. What are the instances in the story that show that the character of the Iron Master is different from that of his daughter? The Iron Master was kind, but not emotional. Edla was different than her father. She was more considerate. He was emotional to a great extent. Whereas you may call her, she was a bit impractical. It is not good to have strangers in her houses, but Edna wanted him because she was feeling Christmassy. She had that spirit of Christmas. Maybe she was strong in a notion that essential goodness can change human beings. But she was so young than her father. What was the difference? Her father was practical, whereas we can say Edna was a little impractical and emotional. The father was also helpful. He wanted to help his comrade, but not a stranger. Edna went few more steps. She wanted to help the stranger whom they have come to know that is not their acquaintance. A little difference in the percentage of kindness and consideration in Edna and her father. The story has many instances of unexpected reactions from the characters to other behaviors. The most important reaction that we share here was the reaction of a rat trap when Iron Master told him that he's going to hand him to the police or to the sheriff. And he reacted in a very excited and panicky way that you yourself will be trapped in a rat trap. And moreover, there is a reaction of Edna, whom the father might have expected that would agree to him, but she wanted to keep. He wanted to keep that man for at least a day, as they have invited themselves. Right? What made the peddler finally change his ways? Very important question. What made the peddler finally change his ways? The peddler changed because of the kindness shown by Edna. Edna is the daughter of the Iron Master. She is described not at all pretty, but modest and quite shy. She's also exceptionally kind. She convinces the peddler to come to her house and then convinces her father to let the peddler stay for Christmas. She is the most positive figure in the story, and her compassion and generosity are the reasons for the peddler's transformation. Her compassion and her generous approach, generous attitude is the most important reason for the transformation of this peddler. We are also calling him the pedestrian or the peddler. Now let's move. How does the metaphor of the rat trap serve to highlight the human predicament? A very important thing, that how does this story serve as a story of human suffering? In the story Rat Trap, the peddler used to sell small rat traps of wire. Thinking of his rat traps, he was suddenly struck by the idea. And moreover, we see that the whole world, at one point, we also realize that yes, the world has a lot of temptations. Thus, the rat trap here serves as a metaphor. It highlights the human suffering of temptations, the alluring world that has a lot of material things to trap us. And the more we are entrapped by them, the more we find ourselves deep into it. And there's no way out, because the more you want, the less you have. The more you run, the lesser you receive. Find these material things. So this way, the rat trap is a metaphor for human suffering. Right, dear students? Are you able to understand? Nachiket?
Yes, ma'am.
Shka, very good. Very good, dear children. So this way we move. You have to work on this question and make stress again and again on this, that how does the metaphor of the rat trap serve to highlight the human predicament? I'll be sharing all the 5 marks, 6 marks question or detailed questions. And we'll be sharing the paper pattern, we'll be sharing these questions also after that, so that we can remember how we have to prepare the detailed questions and how we have to prepare the 2 marks questions, how we have to prepare the 3 marks questions. So it is all on the word limit we have to keep in mind. The peddler comes out as a person with a subtle sense of humor. I have used the word subtleness to meet humor. Is there the humor, the hilariousness in the lesson with the seriousness. I can change the question. Write a note on the seriousness of the story. The subtle means which is there, but you have to find it. Subtlety of humor. What I feel as a reader, as you and me, when we have finished this story, I consider that this story has seriousness as well as humor. There are many instances when we feel hilarious. Most important hilarious episode is the philosophy of the rat trap. But do we or can we ignore the seriousness which is inside it? Or the story moves in a serious note and there's subtle humor in it? Yes, the story, the beggar, the note of seriousness, his sufferings, his struggle, there's humor. Question, can we discuss the humor in the story? Discuss the seriousness of the story or in the story, or discuss humor and seriousness in the story. Do you think there is subtle humor in the story under the canopy of seriousness? So this way we can prepare our questions. The humorous instances are the philosophy of the rat trap. Moreover, he used to sleep with one eye open. If you read between the lines, there is on page number when Edna went to call him and invite him, the man was sleeping with one eye open. And when she removed the hat, she could see that was quite funny. Then moreover, when the way he was invited was quite hilarious, and the way he tried to preach the Iron Master was quite hilarious and humorous, right? So, and moreover, when he offered Edna a letter kept in a rat trap, that was quite humorous. But there was a lot of seriousness in it. So the question is, write a note on the seriousness discussed in the story. I'm repeating, write a note on the humorous aspect of the story. Can we write the subtlety of humor that is there depicted in the lesson? Subtle humor with a serious note, or spontaneous moving of the story with humor and seriousness. This way we can twist our questions, but keep in mind the NCERT questions. What does this NCERT question say? The peddler comes out as a person with a subtle sense of humor. How does this serve in lightening the seriousness of the theme? So whatever I said has been justified with the question of the story and also endure interviews. There is one more question, that where, what is your stand? Do you like to stand with the rat trap or with the Iron Master, or is there any compassion or kindness in the minds of the readers for the rat trap? Right? He's a sufferer of circumstances. He is a culprit who has stolen, but then he is very poor. So we have few points that can be for the rat trap, that we have a stand with the rat trap and we are against the rat trap. It is up to us as readers how we perceive this character. Now, how we perceive this character is, no, the rat trap was a vagabond who stole his benefactor. He does not deserve our sympathy. The question can be, do you think that the rat trap deserves your sympathy? No, because he stole his benefactor. He was a thief, he was a beggar who did not want to work. And when he worked, that was very meager. And if he did not receive anything, he used to thief people. He even thieved the person who helped him out. He used to preach, yes, another side of the coin, yes, our sympathy is the reader's sympathy as a reader. My sympathy is with the rat trap. He was a victim of circumstances who never had anything. The world has never been kind to him. So whatever he received, he gave to the world. This way we have few points to elaborate, two marks questions, right? So this way, the story is both entertaining as well as philosophical. So when it comes to philosophy, the rat traps philosophy will come. When it comes to entertaining, the entertaining part would be the humor and the even the satire on the society, that how society treats the people and then what they receive, they give to the world. Dear students, I hope the story is understood by you all.
Yes, ma'am.
Anushka?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Keep your videos on, dear children, for a moment. Let's end this story here. Let's end the discussion. Thank you.